eyelashes are growing.
Are they?
Look.
Oh, yeah.
It takes literally to get them back. Literally, every single time I've done it, 5 weeks.
Oh, very bad. Hello, everyone, and welcome back to my channel. So, for today's video, it's an exciting one. I'm so excited. But yet nervous, because I'm not sure. I'm really testing my dessert making skills now. I am going to be making mochi. We're gonna go with mochi. It's basically, if you didn't know what mochi is, it's like a Japanese dessert, and it's like got ice cream in the middle, and it's like a squidgy ball thing. That's the best way I can describe it. And if you have been living under a rock, then you'll obviously know what little moons are. Little moons have been going all over TikTok recently, and everyone's been trying to get their hands on them, and Tesco's been running out. Everyone's been going mad for little moons. You either love them, you hate them, blah, blah, blah. Whatever your opinion on them, you can't say they are not going mental at the minute, and I don't know why. In fact, I do know why, because they're just so, like, weird. Like, the texture is so odd. And it took me ages to find some. I did try them, and I did it on a live. But yeah, I liked them, they were really nice. I preferred the vanilla to the passion fruit and mango because those are the two flavours I got. And I literally just wanted, I wanted to make Dolly's ones. I wanted to make my own mochi. Mochi. We're gonna go with mochi for the video. If I'm saying it wrong, I am so, so sorry. I just think that's just how it sounds to me. So we're gonna make our own. But first of all, I have to go get the ice cream. Now, I want it to be as authentic as possible and make them the best I can. And if you didn't know, basically I own a dessert shop called Dolly's Desserts. You can go follow that on whatever social media platforms you like, and it is in Barnsley, which is in the north of England, and we sell desserts, we make our own ice cream, and I thought it would literally just be rude not to make it, like, when I make my own ice cream. But however, we are in the middle of the lockdown and we are not open at the minute, so that is why obviously I can't make a fresh pan for it, like I can't properly do it. However, we have got some Dolly's ice cream in the freezer at work that we saved from last time, so I want to go get some of that to make the mochi, because I just thought buying it from the supermarket, yeah, it's all well and good, but when I make my own ice cream, I really want to use that and like the colours, and I just think it'll look so much better. So we're going to go get the ice cream, then we're going to fetch it back, and we're going to make the mochi. So I'm in the car now, and I'm going to go and get the ice cream from Dolly's, and I will show you when I get there. This honestly just feels so weird, like it's so empty. Obviously we have been in like working and stuff, so there's like random stuff everywhere, but yeah, I've got to get this stuff out of the freezer now. And yeah, this is what it looks like. Not the usual hustle and bustle we used to, that's for sure. Now, I have found bubblegum, well, it's not bubblegum actually, it's unicorn ice cream. But I feel like this one is going to look the best because it's, you know, it's colourful. And then when like, you bite into it, it's going to be like, all different colours. And then I think I'm going to dye like, the actual mochi itself pink. So this is a good go. There was some chocolate in there, but I don't know. I feel like we want to go with the colourful theme. It'll look prettier. And yeah. We are back in my kitchen. Last time you couldn't really hear me, so I don't know whether you can hear me or not. We will see when I'm editing this. However, I'm going to show you what you need, right? I'm not an expert. I have never made this before. This is the inspiration we're going with. We are going with the little moons. Little moons look like this. I'll show you. They look like this. Oh, my one's like at half of one. That's lovely. They look like this. They're squishy. You have to leave them like for 5 minutes before. But yeah, that's what they look like. This is the inspiration we're going for, and let's make them. Now, what you do need is sweet rice flour. So I ordered some of this off Amazon. I think it was like £4. And then I got some cornstarch, because apparently you need cornstarch as well. And I think that was about £4 as well, so not too expensive. Then I have got some of our Dolly's ice cream. We've got unicorn one. I just put some cling film over it in the car journey, so it didn't, you know, spill everywhere.
And this is what it looks like. It looks like a little bit like clumpy and weird, but that's just because we put it into a fresh pan just to store it. It should be fine, and I think it's going to be a really good colour. This is, apparently this is all you need. Oh, you need granulated sugar as well, but I already have granulated sugar. And I also have water, obviously, from the dam. But yeah, that's all you need. It did say, to be fair, that you could use food colouring to dye the squidgy thing. And that is what I'm going to use. So I'm going to get some, I've already got some pink food colouring. And yeah, let's get started. So I'm just going to watch the video here on my mum's laptop because I actually don't own a laptop and I film on my phone. So we're going to be watching it on the laptop.
I went onto YouTube and I watch loads of videos.
Right, so essentially we've got to put the ice cream, scoop it into little bowls and put it onto some parchment paper on a tray, and then we're going to use that, put it in the freezer, and then we're going to make the dough. Okay, so I did get a scoop from Dolly's. These scoops are quite expensive, but you can use any scoop. I'm literally just going to make the scoops and I'm going to put them into the tray. Let's go before the ice cream melts. Okay, so I'm just going to scoop it. Oh, this has not been scooped in so long. I'm going to make like little ones. This like is a good idea to make sure that you wet your scoop. Right, we are scooping it. Scoop, scoop, scoop. Totally sure. This is what it looks like. How cute is that? Ah, I'm so excited. Right, okay. Charlie, put that on there. So we'll just put that onto the parchment paper. I've got to work quick, so let's do it quickly. So this is what they are looking like. Ah, it's moving. Right, let me just move that. Right, these need to go in the freezer ASAP, but I'm only going to make six, so let's quickly put them in the freezer. So it says that we need 160 grams of rice flour, so I'm going to weigh that out, as well as mixing that with 57 grams of granulated sugar. So we're going to do that. Okay, so I am just going to mix it up. I have just weighed out the sugar and the rice flour, and then we are going to add 225 milliliters of water to this, and it should thicken up, apparently. Also, the reason why I am not filming like the actual process is because I'm doing a TikTok for it, and I literally am trying to like film two things at once, so that is why. If you want to go watch the TikTok, you can go do that. We are literally just adding the water, and this is what the consistency looks like. It looks really thin, and I've still got a little bit more water to add, but apparently that's what it's supposed to look like. So I'm gonna trust the process and hope that this is just how it's supposed to look. Apparently you're just meant to keep whisking it. Okay, so what we are gonna do next is cover it in cling film, and then we are gonna pop it into the microwave for 1 minute, and then take it out, stir it, well, mix it, stir it, whatever you want to call it. We're going to put it in for another minute after that. So we're going to put it in the microwave, stir it, put it back in for another minute. I will be back. Okay, so this is what it looks like when it's just been done. I've literally just put it in and it's so thick. I'm literally just going to add some of this pink food colouring to it. And then, yeah, hopefully it looks a little bit better. Right, okay, so next what I'm going to do is literally just wrapped this in cling film, which is like just a board, and then I've just spread out some cornstarch. It's said to be really generous because the mixture is so sticky. I'll literally show you. This is what it looks like, and we're just gonna put some on here. Okay. Definitely is a messy one, and I'm not gonna say it's like the most even. However, this is what it looks like. I had to patch a few bits up. It does look okay. It looks worse on camera for some reason, but honestly, it's not that bad. We're just gonna put it in the fridge for 30 minutes because that's what it says to do. And yes, I will get back to you when it is 30 minutes. Okay, so I'm gonna work quick. However, I have just got these out of the freezer. And for some reason, I don't think that they are gonna stay the like bowl shape. So I'm just gonna follow this other recipe that they did, and they wrapped it in cling film. So I'm gonna wrap the individual balls in cling film. So we're just gonna put it into one like that, and then I'm literally just gonna wrap it up and like just roll it into the shape I want it. About 45 minutes, so let's start making them. I'm so excited. I hope you are. Let's do it. Okay, so now what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna get this like cup because I feel like this is a good size. I've just got this out of the fridge, and then I'm just gonna make like little circles and then wrap the ice cream in it, and yeah,
I'm just gonna have to take a minute because something went wrong. I don't know what went wrong. What went wrong? I literally went to wrap the ice cream balls in the dough, and the dough was just like, it just crumbled, wouldn't wrap. I managed to do two of them really badly and like proper like wrap it up, and I put two of them in the thing, but they do not look good by any means. I've just put them in the freezer. Charlie, I'm so annoying, so I really wanted it to work. I don't even know what I'm gonna do. This is such a pointless video, and I feel like I failed the video because it looks so bad. We will see. Apparently you're supposed to leave them in for a few hours, so we will see. They look so bad. Oh my god, I'm so embarrassed. No, I'm gonna have to make this video again. I really am. I'm gonna try and do the dough again because I'm sure I can crack the dough. It just crumbled. Like, I don't know what I did wrong. Like, where did I go wrong? Who knows? Who knows at all? But yeah, I'll show you what they look like in a bit. No. What do you think?
Yeah.
Wait. No, they're just not it, are they?
I feel like you need to leave them 5 minutes anyway, though. These look good.
I just eat them like that.
Why do they look so thick and massive? Like, yeah, why are they so leave them 5 minutes, still like that.
I know. Alright, let's try and cut this thing in half. Okay. Oh! Okay, they look good from the inside. Like, let's see how they taste.
It's a bit thick. That bit's really soft, and then that's like, I like it.
I don't even think I want to try it. No, thanks.
No, no, it's just a big no. No, no, no.
Oh, God, where did I go wrong?
It tastes powdery.
It does, doesn't it? Maybe I put too much cornstarch on, but it's said to be generous.
But like I said, I think I am going to try that again because I want to redo that dough. I am not giving up on Little Moons. I'm going to do this again. I'm not letting it defeat me. But that is the end of today's video. Thank you so much for watching if you got this far. And yeah, make sure to like and subscribe. Bye.